Welcome to Ion Entertainment. I'm Dawna Lee Heising, and today we have special guests here. This is the West Coast producer for Dark Ronin Films, Suzanne Stevens Breitenbach. And this is Bill Murray, and what's your title?
Actually, right now I'm the lead administrator for the China White Group and the China White Credits and Reels, and an admin for the Dark Ronin Films.
And lead administrator for China White fan page.
Right.
That's quite a title. Okay.
Can we put that on one card?
Okay, and that's Chris Yanke, and tell us what your title is.
I'm technical support administrator for China White fan page and recently silenced the film, as well as the Dark Ronins. Am I coming on board to help that? I provide 24-hour technical support to anybody that has my phone number, and I'm also an actor in the China White movie.
Well, officially, you're not there yet, but
okay.
You just came on this, so...
Oh, oops.
That's okay.
Okay, well, I'm so excited to finally meet you. I've been working with Suzanne. Suzanne is the driving force, I have to say, behind the success of China White, the fan page. I mean, it's got... How many members do we have now?
I think we have 2,212 today on China White, which is an 8-week anniversary. And we aren't even 1 week with Silence, and we're at 712.
Now, she has quite a business background, and I want to get into that because I know that that's the reason why it's so successful. But first, let's talk to Bill and let's find out his history. Now, how did you get involved with show business?
It's really a funny story. You know, when Ghostbusters came out and Bill Murray, the actor, was big thing at the time, and everybody used to tease me at work. So I said, well, I'm going to show you guys. I'm just going to do it since you teased me about it so much. And I've been doing it ever since 1986.
Okay, you've been acting. How did you get into it?
That's another funny story too, is that I had a what they call a penny saver or a recycle magazine, and it said, you know, be in movies and stuff like that. So I answered an ad, and you know, I liked it, and I was working at a major aircraft company at the time, so I had time off that I could do a day or two here. And
what did you do at the aircraft company?
I was a coordinator for Hughes Aircraft Company, and I was also an expediter for the same company for about 9 years.
Wow.
So okay. Aerospace basically mm-hmm. was more of my background. Mm-hmm. And then when I answered the ad and they liked my look and they started calling me, then I would take vacation time off and sick days, whatever I was allowed to, but because I couldn't give up that job. And then when that job moved out of the state, then I stayed here and I just, you know, went back into doing background work, extra work. Mm-hmm. And eventually in 96, I was working on two films at the time. One was Crime of the Century, and the other one was Men in Black. And I was able to be a photo double for Tommy Lee Jones in the first Men in Black, that's how I got my Taff Hartley.
Oh.
So it was from there, I just kept going in and out of the business, and when things picked up in other areas, I worked outside of the business, and I always just came back, you know, in and out for that time period.
That must have been exciting, working for Tommy Lee Jones.
It was really kind of cool, you know, it was done over at Sony Studios. I had my own trailer, and it was like, you know, just starting out, it was like, wow, this is a pretty cool thing. And I worked just as his photo double for a short period of time. Mm-hmm. And
well, I mean, you're a lot younger, but I can see that.
Actually, we're quite a bit the same age, and we're almost the exact same size, except that he's broader than I am.
Oh, you're the same age?
He's a quarter of an inch.
He just
taller
had 32 days ago.
Than I am. And he won't let you forget that. He tells you that too. He says, I'm 5'11 and a quarter, and don't you forget that quarter inch.
Okay.
So I'm a quarter inch shorter than he is, but we're the same clothes, everything else, and it was just a cool experience.
Okay.
You know?
Well, I knew that he had a great business background because he's been another driving force behind the fan page. He keeps And you keep Todd sheltered too, like so that all of us can't harass him, which is great. You do a great job at that.
Oh, thank you. Yes, that's my job.
It's a hard job because we all want to harass him.
If you have any issues on the page, get in touch with me first before you go any higher. And I'll try to solve the problem, and if I can't, then I'll find out for you.
Okay. Now, Chris, how did you get into show business? Well, you know, tell us about your history. I know that you... Well, how did you get into technical support and software?
It just started... Am I close enough, by the way? I hope I'm... I don't want you to have... I really don't want you to have to stretch and be uncomfortable. Hi, I'm a ham. I started off in technical support just by being the one guy that knew how to use a computer. All my life, I was kind of a recluse, shut-in. Can you believe that?
No.
Yeah. Believe it or not, yes, I knew it. I knew Suzanne was going to say it. I'm like, one of them is going to roast me in the roasting panel. No, I actually, being an entertaining person, it's misleading. People think, oh gosh, you're really social. You love to come out and talk to people. No, I'm not. I'm actually doing that because, you know, I have a hard time being around people. I want them to laugh. So, you know, I'm putting on a performance. Well, when I go home, I'm actually very reclusive. Well, computers and TV became my friends. So when Ghostbusters came out for me when I was 12,
Thank you very much.
That same year, Betamax was big. What a great idea that was for Sony. Just kidding. But in during that time, I had always heard as a kid, "Gosh, you should be in TV." So of course, I started getting in school plays, and I was single parent. I was raised by my dad, which is really rare. But between music and plays, that was how I entertained myself. And so when I would watch these sitcoms, that's what I would emulate. Mm-hmm. Which made it really difficult to have a real relationship because, you know, when you're just repeating what you see, being impressionable, you don't realize when it's not good to be funny. Imagine being in a relationship with me. I was imagining I was in a lot of relationships. So it started there. I'm serious. But when I went to high school, I started acting. My first play was an Agatha Christie play, so I did practice accents, and foreign language is something I've always been interested in because I talk so much. So from there, I graduated. I had an acting scholarship that I didn't take advantage of because I decided it made more sense to work customer service and stay home. Brilliant business decision made by a 19-year-old boy. So I stayed in Seattle, and from there I developed an interest in helping people with technology and finance. Mm-hmm. It was really, it's like what a lot of us do. We look at, we distract ourselves, but we look at what's in your life, what in your life could be made better. You know, that whole third eye or third set of eyes sort of thing. And that's what started. I started working at what was then known as Microsoft Windows 3.1 and Windows NT 3.5, and later evolved into the products that we would come to know, and also Apple products that just became that person people called. Okay. From there, it was a long history of that. But when things kind of got bad in the mid-2000s, I had to rely on my skill set to do whatever I could to survive. And promotions, making coffee, which I love to make coffee. okay. Anything I could started from there, and it brought me to a point where I had no choice but to do something I wanted to do, which was entertain.
Okay.
And that brought me here in February of 2011. So that's how I arrived. That's been a while.
Okay. And Chris got Taft Hartley on his first set, and I believe that you've been on your 189th set now?
189 sets, yes.
In a year, which is amazing.
I used to be a lot bigger than this. Yeah, it's a great weight loss program. Just work a bunch of sets, and yes, this is set one number 189, but I was Taft Hartley on my very first project by director Jen Page of Luminave Films. She came up to me. I was a set cook, and said, "Have you ever acted?" And of course, my response: my first two marriages. And she laughed and brought me in. And I was it was a part specifically for me because of my face. So, yes, it's great to have a talent. Okay. Yes. So there you go. That's all I have.
Okay. Now, Suzanne is the West Coast producer of Dark Ronin Films, and. She's got an amazing background, so I'll let her tell you about it.
Okay. Basically, I have a Bachelor of Science degree in accounting. I have an MBA in business administration. I have a dissertation short of a PhD in international business, and I am a certified management accountant, not public, it's management, which means that I am an inside person on organizations that runs operations rather than just looking at it from an auditing standpoint. And I have held CEO or CFO positions in troubled companies for over 25 years. And I have been a professor at the graduate level for over 20 years in probably 10 different universities. And the last one I was hired at, I had a contract where I was in a sister organization or university in Paris, and I was going to move there and teach in two of their universities, one in English and one in French. And at the last minute, I had to break the contract in 2000 to become my mother's caretaker, and that's when I retired.
Oh, okay, I didn't know that part of it.
Yeah.
Okay, was your husband going to go with you then?
No, he was going to stay here, but the university was actually going to pay to fly him over five times a year.
Oh, okay.
And they were going to give me an apartment, they were going to feed me, they were going to do everything for me to get me over there. So that was quite an honor, and that was going to break into my international consulting, mm-hmm. because I do speak French, and they wanted my American business background to help them in their troubled companies. So that was going to be my opening for that.
Uh-huh.
But because of my mother's illness, I retired.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, tell us about your mother.
Well, my mother got very ill, and she needed full-time caretaking, and I always promised her that I would never put her in a home as long as she still had a mind. And I lived up to that, and she died in my arms.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, I was just wondering if...
That's okay.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry.
And then I've always been a huge lover and a supporter of the arts. I am season ticket owners to the theater, the ballet, the opera, the symphony, and a huge supporter of the arts all through these years.
Mm-hmm.
And after I retired, my mind is a business mind, and also I need to keep busy, and I met Todd, and I started reading his scripts.
Mm-hmm.
And
now, how did you meet Todd?
I met him through Kenny Maranta.
Okay.
And so we just started hitting it off together, and he started sending me his scripts. And I said to him, has anybody ever referred to you as Hitchcock? And he said, no, why? And I said, you've got that edge to you, and I like you. And I want to somewhat come out of retirement and help you and give you the business end to your talent. The rest is history.
Oh my gosh, Todd is so lucky that you decided to do that. Now tell us about your husband.
My husband is a retired physician and a lawyer, and he retired about 5 years after me.
Mm-hmm.
And we just love it. So we travel and we just experience the arts, and this gives me my business sense and also my love of the arts at the same time. And so I'm very, very passionate about it. And then I met Shannon, and I got mm-hmm. those two together. And Shannon really likes me and my business sense. And so he grabbed me on to Dark Ronin Films. And I love his talent. I've read his scripts.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm very, very excited about the whole thing. And I'm doing a little acting.
A little. Okay, we'll get to that. Now, you see the business backgrounds of the people involved in China White and
Silence.
Shannon
and
Silence. And Shannon has a great business background too. I've always believed that's what's really important in making a film successful, is that people know the business background. And who better than a management consultant?
Well, also Shannon, he has, well, you know, in business, that's a left brain function. Art is a right brain function. I don't
mm-hmm.
have that right brain function. I just am an enjoyer of it. I'm extremely left brain. But Shannon actually has both. He has a business sense, and he's artistic. So that's a huge talent to bring to the base. Then I bring the business in, and Todd, he brings strictly the artistic in. So
mm-hmm.
I think the three of us together can really do some great things.
Well, you already have, but you're going to be playing the wife in the mother in Silence.
No, the psychiatrist.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I thought you were the mother. I was going to say that. So.
No, I'm going
okay.
to be playing the psychiatrist for Caitlin.
Okay. Well, then that will come pretty naturally then.
Cause right. Okay. Right. Like the miniseries I just did, they had me playing a tough lawyer. Gee, can we spell typecasting? Yeah.
Oh, your husband must have been excited about that, though, right?
Yeah, I would practice my lines for him, and I'd say, well, is this a lawyer look and talk? And he would say, well, that's a pretty tough lawyer. And I said, well, that's what I need to be.
You know, I mean, I know you can be tough because you've been so successful in business, but you're so nice, too.
Well, you have to be tough to be a CEO, and, you know, you have to be the good guy and the bad guy, and I usually play the role of the bad guy. And, you know, good cop, bad cop type thing. Uh-huh. But in my heart, I really do care about the people that work for me, and I love them. And I think that I get a good following and people working hard for me because they know I really do care. And that's important.
Well, you can tell from the Facebook page. I mean, Suzanne welcomes everyone in there. I don't know how you have the time, but because it keeps growing.
Well, I am less and less time. But I brought Bill in the very first day because I had known him from another group, and he's an expert on Facebook. And so I asked him to come in and just kind of take over for the Facebook end of it, and then I'm just the welcoming person, and he's been the brains behind the Facebook page.
Okay, well, when did you start the Facebook page?
Well, I started my personal page back in 2009, and then I created a group in January of this year for background artists, and then I met Suzanne through there, and she asked me to come aboard with the China White to help her organize the page and things like that. So we put in the docs and files and things like that, and hopefully that people will adhere to the rules and regulations of the group function. And so I kind of, you know, answer questions for people and help them out with that.
We also felt, or Bill felt, that it was really important for the pages that we developed to make them exciting for the fans. In other words, it wasn't just a constant link of the actors posting their reels and links and self-promotion, because that starts to get boring and people leave. Mm-hmm. It's exciting for everybody in the profession, but it's not so exciting for the fans. Mm-hmm. So the only people we allow to actually have links on the fan page are the cast members, because the fans want to know about the cast. We actually have been getting requests for autographs all around the world.
Oh.
And it's just amazing. And then Bill created another page that's called China White Silence Credits and Reels, which is just for the professionals to give their information back and forth and ask for people to like their things and stuff like that. It's very efficient, it works beautifully, and I'm really proud of it.
Well, it's amazing. I mean, when I first came into the group, there was the doc section where you could go for scripts and sides and rules for the group. I mean, it's really amazing how you put it together.
That was through the help with Chris, Yanke, and you know, a couple of other people that we brainstorm these ideas, and then we make a little package, and then we post it in a file, a doc.
Okay, now how did Chris get involved in this then?
Bill, could you answer that? Because I'm still, how did I get involved? I think it was a lot of angry phone calls to you. Because between sets of working.
Well, did you know each other before this?
We did. Actually, yeah. Bill's group, BGA. Actually, can you take it from here? Bill, well, do you want to drive?
We Chris and I did a couple of student film projects together. AFIs.
Oh.
And we met there. And then we worked
together.
Those
are really student films. I mean, those are great films.
They are.
Yeah, American film is really good. Yeah, mm-hmm. We met there and we got to work out a couple of days in a row, didn't we?
Right. And then we also met on a couple of other TV shows. And things just clicked. And I liked his energy. And he's a very intelligent person.
Seemingly.
Well,
and you learned
you got me fooled then if you're not.
Yeah. You know, see, when you hear of acting, there's right brain, left brain, and there's no brain. So
that's basically how Chris and I got together. And then I brought him in with, I was telling Suzanne about him because of his brilliance. And so we just brought him in as well, and now he's a tech admin in the China White group.
Okay, and tell us what you do as a tech admin.
Well, really quickly, what had happened when Bill met me, again,
my close enough. Kind of far away.
I know, as somebody who wants to be a lead singer here, at the time he met me, my uncle passed away. He was my attorney also as well, and he had called me, and I used to help him a lot with technical issues, because he's one of those people, I always used to say, I'm caught between the jaws of a generation that won't learn until it's too late. You know who you are. And then, of course, I'm stuck between another generation that thinks it's too late to learn. So between the not learning till it's too late and the other one thinking it's too late to learn, in between, you have my generation. And I looked at Bill and I said, why not find a way to make this better? Because the worst burden is potential when it's carried, and that's misusing it. You know why? Because when you carry burden, you realize 100% of us can do, but so few of us are willing to. And I was just pissed at the point that he met me. Remember that? Remember how angry I looked? It was because we've got all this time and all this social technology and all this potential out there. And so why not find a way to use it? And simple. Take five things that we know everybody in the industry is looking for. Your face, your name, a way to get a hold of you, what you've done, and what you want to do. There you go. You can reach out with your arm and grasp with your hand. And Credits and Reels was born. I didn't have the time, though. I mean, I can sit and work for my phone more often than not I am. And so, being a tech support person, what I try to do is I try to find a way, I look for the way the person communicates. I speak German and Spanish, but I'm looking, do you speak in ways that are very left brain oriented, very specific terms, or are you right brain? Do you need, you know, euphemisms? And that's how I started incorporating the tech support thing. Well, everybody decided that I was a great person to call. And so that
Well, Bill and I really thought so, yeah.
I hope that hasn't changed.
Longer to you, yeah.
Yeah, so there you go. That's part of the philosophy. That's part of what drives me. You know, that's the engine behind the steering wheel with the weird last name. And that's, it really is. But
Are you left-brained or right-brained then?
You know, it's hard. It just depends on the day of the week. I'm one of those men that...
So you're both.
I think. Mm-hmm. But... let's put it this way. I'm really
to be determined.
Yeah, TBD. Yeah, can we go ahead and put a TBD label on that, and we'll go DNQ does not qualify. So, okay. But yeah, so I'm thinking quarterly report on this one, please. Accounting, help me.
Okay.
But I tend to take in any way the brain can be used. It's like, look, everybody, every flower starts off as a seed. Everybody has a chance to flourish, and in that, whether it's me, my words to inspire, or whether it's something I do, I want to live my life as an example of showing people that I'm human and that you can overcome certain things, like everybody. So okay. Seriously, there you go.
Okay.
Did that make sense?
Yeah, it did. And that's great that you're taking care of all the technical issues then, so it must take a lot of time.
It sure does. And I say that with a sarcastic, it sure
I
does.
Know,
but
the
thing is that, you know what's rewarding is at the end of it, when some of the people that you know, the thing is that, you know, rather than being sarcastic and letting them know that you're frustrated, you really don't want to do that. What you're doing is that you're seeing in them how they want to learn, but the blocks that either they're putting in front of themselves, and you're helping them remove those obstacles. And at the end of the call, when you hear, thanks, I know how to do this, you've helped me so much. I mean, it takes the previous 2 hours of punching the walls and makes it so much more worth it. I think it's like parenting on a much shorter scale. So it does take time. But it's very worthwhile because is it time for me to quit? But yes, it's very rewarding. Very rewarding.
Okay, and have you kicked him yet?
And cut. Okay, and that's all I have to say.
Okay, now when you started working with Todd, did you start the China White schedule before you met Shannon then, or was
yes?
Was he,
we were involved in the China White, and
How did you decide China White was the first one to start with?
Because that was the first script I read from him. So I started bugging him, saying, I don't know about the inside of this industry, but I'm a damn good businesswoman, so please let me help. And he thought about it and thought about it and thought about it. And then he finally said, okay, Suzanne. I said, okay, I'm starting the page today. And I started it, pulled him in the next day, and it just flourished.
And I'm
pretty proud of it. I'm pretty proud of it, yeah.
It is so nice to have these two to default, you know, to, because, I mean, I have to rely on either one of them, either for support. You know, you want to get some guidance, and having both of them, you know, to take time out of their day and deal with me is really nice. It's a nice resource. Because there'll never be a time in my life that I won't need to stop and learn something. And mm-hmm. Bill and Suzanne have had to take hours out of their days.
Well, okay. The professor and me really does like to teach and nurture and help people grow. I was never one in the corporate world that felt threatened about somebody wanting to bite at my heels and take my job. I say bite all you want. I'll teach you everything I know, because as soon as the corporation ran smoothly, I'm bored and I want to leave. So then I want to jump into another mess.
Yes.
So I like teaching and making people grow and actually be as good as and pass me. I like to see that.
Okay, now how did you get into acting?
Well, like I said, I fell in love with the arts, mm-hmm. and then I decided, well, I'll just give it a shot. And I've done pretty well, and...
You've done really well. So are you taking lessons?
No, I don't take lessons. I just rely on my life and mm-hmm. the emotions of that life. And okay. So far, I've hit some pretty nice things. I didn't realize I was doing well until Bill, with all his experience, told me, well, Suzanne, a lot of people wait a lot of time to get some of the roles you've had, so I'm very pleased.
Uh-huh. Okay, so tell us about China White, the story.
Well, Bill might be able to discuss that better since he's actually in the story, but it's a crime drama action, and it's not just filled with action and blow-up scenes and screeching tires. This is what I like about Todd. He has a Hitchcock approach to it, which is very simplistic. His segues from one scene to another is phenomenal. And the basic whole concept is just a really good story. And he tells it so well. So you're going to get every emotion that you have, a human emotion. Throughout the whole film, you're going to cry, you're going to laugh, you're going to be scared, you're going to be touched, you're going to be aghast at some of the actions that people take toward another, which, you know, like is the betrayal, revenge, and then redemption. It's really a nice story.
And it's a really tight script, too. Did you help with that?
Oh, no, I don't do any script writing. And what Todd liked about me is that I don't know this industry. So when I read a script, I can give an outsider's point of view. I'm a typical audience, rather than being somebody from the industry and saying, well, this is wrong, that's wrong, whatever. But when I read any of his scripts, I sit down and I can't put it down. I read it from the first page to the last. And I found that the same with Shannon's scripts. I cannot put it down. And when I'm supposed to cry, I cry. And I'm supposed to laugh, I laugh. And I like bringing that emotion out in me. Because as an old woman, or an older woman...
Will you stop saying that? You look so young.
Well, thank you. I'm 62 years old, and I'm very proud of every one of them.
I would never guess.
Well, thank you.
Well, you're
much.
Beautiful.
Well, thank you very much. And I like having those emotions. And I like a film to make me feel emotional. Mm-hmm. And...
Well, why didn't you put yourself in China White?
Well, I don't think Todd offered me anything. He has seen some of my work, but when he saw my work, he said, I want you as the psychiatrist in Silence. Will you take it? I said, sure, I'll take it.
Oh, okay. Well, so then he knew he had that coming up for
you.
Yeah,
he saw a reel on me, and he said, I want you in this one. So okay. I just don't think there's a role for me in China White that would fit.
Yeah, well, I'm playing a stripper in it, so
I don't think you'd want a 62-year-old woman trying to be a stripper.
Well, you know, as a background, I did submit for background, and I just want to know the answer is no. I think it takes a lot of sacrifice, though, to know when there is and isn't a role, and I think a lot of actors should probably start with that, because we all think, why didn't I get that? Why didn't, you know?
Yes.
And you realize the people that truly are dedicated to the arts, as mentioned by Suzanne, you know, that it takes a lot to say, you know, maybe there isn't a role. And it takes a lot of patience.
I didn't think there wasn't one for me. It's just not a film for me. Not because I don't love it. There's just not a role for me.
Yeah, it takes a lot. I don't
well,
have
plus you're doing all the business behind it, too, so.
Yeah. That keeps him pretty busy.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, now tell us about your role in China White.
Well, I submitted for the chief of police, and I was, unfortunately, I didn't get that role, but that then he offered me internal affairs agent.
Oh,
so,
okay.
I mean, I'm just happy to be part of the movie. It, if I, whether I got a role or not, I'm still there, you know, supporting it.
Mm-hmm.
I noticed on a couple of other sites that once they found out they didn't get roles, they were gone.
Oh, yes.
So I, but I believe in the movie, and I believe in Todd and Suzanne and what's going on with it. And that's my kind of movie anyway, because I'm always the detective or the bad gangster guy or the, you know, the lawyer. I have that type of
persona.
Yeah.
He's very paternal. I mean, I look at Bill. Yeah, I hate to say father because a couple years older than my dad now, but at the same time, Bill's been a real guy. He's got that guiding personality. I mean, you look at this guy and you just want him to be in charge. Mm-hmm. You know, like, so.
Well, he is in charge, quietly, but strongly. You know, as being a member of the group, I know.
So, yeah, that's basically what, you know, I like about it. And, like, with the silence, I saw that there was not something in there for me, so I didn't even bother to submit mm-hmm. for it, but I'm still supportive of it. You know, Todd's got several projects coming up behind that.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe there's something more in there, or maybe not. To me, it doesn't matter as long as I'm involved with it.
Yeah, like he has the same passion for the art and for Todd's talent. That and his dedication to me, that he's in there for the long haul.
We won't let him go.
He's not going to want to go.
I mean, we call this the 3D formula, where you're dedicated, you're driven, and you're devoted. And nothing says that more in your actions. And a lot of actors, you know, I've only been doing this for a year and 3 weeks.
But who's counting?
Yeah. But who's counting? Well, I mean, when you have a goal in mind, you know that sometimes you have to accept that the way you wanted to be in it, you know, as kids, growing up, we all have to deal with disappointment. The 4D, we left that one out. Marketing didn't like it. But you manage your life that way and realize that part of that sacrifice is being humble enough to know, you know, I've got a lot of other great opportunities that can happen because this one didn't. So maybe that's the opportunity. And you find people that just, you know, it's unfortunate that aren't, but I think because of this experience and what they've just, you know, demonstrated, 50, we're going to mm-hmm. see that you get a higher quality, you know, you get the dedicated to show themselves in this art.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I like this film, actually both of them, is because, you know, every one of us has had to deal with the disappointment of not getting something they wanted.
I think all of us, though, have a business background, too. I think that's the difference, maybe.
If you're leaning more towards the value of teaching business and what it means, ethics, thank you, 1998, then, yeah, I see your point.
Okay.
Sorry. But I do see your point that yes, there is some value in the experience and understanding that you know, opportunity isn't something to be had but to be shared.
Okay, so tell us about your role in China White.
Well, as you can imagine, Bill's my boss. I'm one of the internal affairs agents.
What a surprise.
Yes, I know. And as you can imagine, so between the two of them, Suzanne gets the calls in the morning, Bill gets them in the evening, and each one an hour. I was very excited. Todd called me, and of course, he apparently laughed the whole time. Do I sound funny? I was really excited. It was 2 weeks ago, actually, today, that I got the phone call. And
you're very endearing.
Enduring. Is enduring entertaining? What's the third E? No, I'm just kidding. Don't, as long as,
enthusiastic.
Yes, I know.
Yes.
Appreciate
great.
The trip three E.
Excited.
Yeah, I know.
Exciting.
I know. Don't get to A where annoying is. Let's not do that. No, between Suzanne, Bill, and I mean, I looked at it as even if I didn't get a role, I would still be trying to open doors with, you know, with the relationships and everything and trying to help the film meet its goal. I decided I was going to make that commitment. And I know that there's a lot of other things that I have to be intelligent enough to know that I could appear to be neglecting, but I'm not. You know, I mean, I still have to go out and work. I still have to mm-hmm. do background. Yay. And it's a challenge to do that, but I know why I'm doing it. It's only, sacrifice is only wasted when you forget your direction. Well, I'm not going to. And so, you know, and when I got offered the role, it was just further enthusiasm, excitement, in another E word, entertaining. I was very excited to get it. So
okay.
Bill will be my boss.
And do you have a family?
I do not. I'm a single male. I was in an 8-year relationship.
He's available, ladies.
Okay. Yeah. Look at these eyes.
I never get no compliments about my chest or anything else. He's got great eyes.
Oh God, he's gonna show us his chest.
If I did, you better start looking at the floor. No, so then you're gonna see my chest.
I mean, look at how blue his eyes are.
Close up. Hi. Sorry, are we in frame? Beverly, no, but back. I was in an 8-year relationship, and then we decided that back in Seattle, I had to come down here and do this, but it took me another 8 years, so.
Okay. What about you? Do you have a family?
I have a significant other that we share a nice little chateau in Granada Hills.
Okay. And how does your husband feel about all this? Does he want to get involved since he's... Oh, that was quick!
Is that too quick?
Well, let me stretch this out as press
is
secretary.
Interested?
I'm completely the business end in our family. He's a physician and a lawyer. I'm business. And, but he likes the artistic end of it because we are so involved in the arts and we are huge supporters of the arts. Actually, we travel the world to watch operas and ballets and stuff. And it's an exciting new part of the arts that we're bringing into it.
Okay, now with your business background, since you've been the CEO of several companies, can you mention any of them?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Because most of them were in trouble when I was their CEO.
Okay, and then you fix them, and then you get bored and move on.
Yes.
Okay, you're not going to do that to us, are you?
No, I'm not.
Okay, so... I mean, you built up Todd's brand, with China White. Now you've moved, or you haven't moved, actually, you've brought China White into Dark Ronin Films.
Correct.
So now you're involved in, can you tell us what your business priorities are with Dark Ronin Films?
Well, my Dark Ronin Films aspirations are first to align with Todd and get these first two films into the can, but... Mm-hmm. I'm also talking to Shannon about working with him on his other projects, and so then I don't know if Todd would be directing them or whatever, but I am split between them and also collectively. And
okay.
I think both men are extremely talented. I'm excited about both of them.
Okay, are you?
And I'm honored that Shannon made me his West Coast office. So.
Oh, how could he not? After seeing how you work, I mean, it's like results immediately. That's really the difference between this group. I mean, Facebook is what you make out of it, but I think because of the business expertise of all of these people, if you go to the China White page, you'll just see what they're talking about.
It's efficient, and everybody that's in it is passionate about the project, and it shows, which I think is part of our being able to build a team and to build people that want to follow and get involved in the excitement and become emotionally, just like I used to build corporations. Because when you're in a very stressful, chaotic corporation that doesn't have leadership, they need to believe in their leader and to follow them to keep them working for a common goal. And that's what we're trying to do.
Oh, that's so wonderful. I mean, being in Hollywood for a while, it's amazing to find someone like Suzanne. That's why I feel like I'm part of the family now.
You are part of the family.
Good luck.
I can't tell you.
Oh, yes, it's time now for everybody's favorite segment. It's the prize segment.
Well, it's not the prize segment.
What is it, Bill?
This is our China Hat White that we're only selling it on... Actors Anarchy's Brian the Hammer Shop.
Yes,
and the proceeds of it go to the Cancer Relay Research. But we brought this here hat for you.
Oh my gosh, oh thank you.
Can I hold the microphone while you try it on?
It will, I'll hold it and try it
on. Yes,
there you go.
I was telling them, and Renah knows, I have an MBA in business too, and I'm in marketing, but acting is not, I have a wonderful husband who takes care of me, but I need my own spending money, so I'm looking for a part-time business job, so I told Brian that I would buy a hat when I got the job. So I'm hoping to work for Renah, too, who is our EOE producer. She is a professor at Golden West and head of the digital media department. But Anyway,
in fact, you got your MBA from Pepperdine, which my credentials helped get their business accreditation.
That's amazing. And then also, my husband teaches part-time at Chapman, and you've worked...
I worked for Chapman for many, many years, teaching at their Air Force base off of El Segundo, teaching the Air Force officers their MBAs.
So, are your duties now with Dark Ronin Films, are they fulfilling all of your needs since you've done so many things?
Oh, yes. I'm very excited, and it's filling all of my needs, so...
And more,
I'm
actually,
in for the long haul.
Okay. Well, tell me about your part as a psychiatrist, then, in Silence.
Well, I don't know that much about it, except for I read the script, and I really like it. And I like playing a strong woman. Gee. And I'm going to help Caitlin through her issues after being raped and trying to deal with that, because I'm very, very attached to women's issues and to the abuse and things like that. In fact, I did a PSA commercial for women and child molestation. That should be coming out in the next couple weeks. So I feel very, very strongly about these things.
Oh, great. Well, you're going to put it on the page then, the credits and reels page.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, well, thank you all for coming and visiting with me today. This was a really important show. Those who are in the group know all about the family, the China White family, and now the Dark Ronin Films family, which you'll probably soon be a part of.
Oh, please call me at 3 a.m. if you have any technical issues. I'll be looking forward to your calls starting now.
Well, this IMDb issue must have just really driven you all crazy. That I mean,
No, we might have started out there as crazy. No, I realize you guys got that resolved really quickly, though. Which IMDb issue are we talking about?
I don't know. I just saw a million posts on something.
Shannon went ahead and he got us IMDb credit for China White, and we're very excited that he went ahead and made us official, and all the cast and the fans are also very excited.
And Shannon also designs the logos, too, so visit the webpage, which
is... And the posters.
Oh, that's
and
right.
And the posters. The China White poster, I think, really... expresses the edginess of Todd's talent. Like I said, that Todd, I feel, is the modern day Hitchcock. Mm-hmm. And so when Shannon made that poster on the side, rather than being a straight poster, I just immediately told him it's edgy, I like it, it's black and white, which I like preferred that more than color. Mm-hmm. And I fell in love with it. Then he did the Silence poster. And then the inside picture is cockeyed. And then he wrote the cast in the top corner, which I think was very edgy. I like edginess, so mm-hmm. I think it attracts people.
And that one's black and white, too.
And that's also black and white, yeah.
Well, actually, now that I have this hat, let's also talk about Brian, because he is a big part of promoting Dark Ronin Films.
And China White, yes. Mm-hmm. We got involved with him, and China White actually is an official sponsor now of Brian the Hammer Show.
How did you get involved with him?
You know what? It was Bill. Mm-hmm. Bill brought me to him.
Oh, okay. Well, how did you find him?
Well, you know, it was a fun thing because...
Yeah, actors, he's fun.
Actors Anarchy and Actors Media Breakdown were friends of mine on Facebook for over a year, and... I would go to them and say, oh, hey, guess what? I got this and I got that. And they were, yay, you know, they were kudos. Mm-hmm. And they were really supportive of me. And then when I got involved with China White, I was telling Suzanne, I said, Suzanne, we got to talk to Todd. We got to get him on the blog radio show. And so Suzanne talked to Todd, and we worked that out with Kelly from Actors Media Breakdown and Brian the Hammer from Actors Anarchy, and
do they work together?
Yeah, yes. Kelly is your producer.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Right,
he's his producer. Uh-huh.
And so then things just went from there, and they did their interviews, and they've been asked back several times.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then we got the hats. We made the hats, and Brian said, "Well, we'll sell them in our shop." He has a hammer shop on the Facebook page. And so we negotiated with them, and then we, you know, said the proceeds would go to their foundation, which was the Cancer Relay Research. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of funny because I went to another cast party and I met you there.
I know.
And I says, you know, Dawna, what are the chances of having Todd on your show? And that's how that happened.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, you two worked all that out, or right. You and Todd, or I don't know how that worked out.
Doesn't matter.
I was just back there.
It came together.
Actually, it's amazing because Todd is in Colorado. We usually do interviews like this, as Renah knows, because she does a lot of them with me in person. But with Todd, it was our first Skype interview, and it got 42,000 hits.
That's
wonderful.
Yeah.
So, shows you how explosive the growth of his brand is.
It also shows your talent in the interviewing process. So.
Oh, thank you. So, well, you were telling me more about Brian.
Well, he's got the blog radio show on. It comes on at 10 a.m. every day.
Mm-hmm.
And he's branching it out to other...
He's got the sports show on today.
He's got a sports show on today.
Is that new?
Yeah,
today is the first day. Okay. It's inaugural day.
And
I know Arlene has a segment on it as the entertainment reporter.
Exactly. Unscripted.
And there is Chris Yanke as co-host of that.
When did this happen? that's great.
Okay.
I wish you had been there when I was on it.
Why didn't you tell me? I would have. I was probably working that day on another lovely set. But in all seriousness, Arlene, when Arlene was offered, we talked over the phone, and I said, listen, I get up really early in the morning, and I read some publications, and I can give you the top three stories, I can quote my sources, and I'll send you the link. And so I used to get up and text her, you know, everything, and we started working together, and she called me up one day, she goes, why aren't you promoting yourself? I want to promote you. And I'm like, because I have a big mouth and I talk, I don't need to. And,
for radio?
And Brian, Brian insisted that I call in, and Kelly, and what would happen is I would call in, and I would end up waiting and waiting and waiting. Mm-hmm. And as much as I talk, I also listen. And what had happened is all the other guests would essentially talk over me, and we'd have to wait. And Brian and Kelly were very apologetic, and they'd say, listen, come back on the next day. And then finally, after about a week of this, Brian said, you know, you're my Matt Damon. And he brought up another show where Matt Damon always gets brought on but can never appear because he's... So he gave me 20 minutes this last week to finally sit down and talk, and I got to talk to a couple of political analysts, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And do, you know, to get to share a lot of different things that day. So I do appear on the show, but I try to keep it down. But Arlene and I, what would happen is she's a mom. She's got all these different businesses.
Yeah.
I'm not. And, and you know, I mean, as far as father material goes, I mean, I'll still get up early. I just got nailed on Brian the Hammer show. But, I mean, we started talking about promotional ideas. I'm like, you know, rather than having pin-up centerfolds, have Brian the Hammer's nailed down never folds for, you know, we all started clothed. The conversation just flourished. And Arlene and I shared, because of her busy schedule, it's like, you know, it's easy to give her a few little tips and help her, and then let her incorporate some of the stories she has. And we started working together. But she understood my schedule was busy, and from there it just went. So.
Well, congratulations. I think that's a perfect marriage. Entertainment marriage.
Out of state? I was going to say, a perfect marriage for me, it would be out of state. Yes. But she, she's been very kind, and I'll get to meet her next week.
Because I know she's on The Lobbyist, too, and that's a web series, so that must take time.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's the thing is that, you know, when you look at somebody's schedule, like if you're just being somebody's coach, and I'm looking at their schedules, and I'm thinking about the amount of time everybody has to invest in things, you say, well, what can I do to help that? Even though they're going to help me, don't worry, I'm thinking about me.
Uh-huh.
And in Arlene's case, you know, that's how we came to be, is with her busy schedule, it's like, what complementary activities can I do that only take a little bit of time? And mm-hmm. I think the willingness there really opened her up to helping me. She's given me a lot of professional advice, and I need it. And mm-hmm. so she's been wonderful. And Brian, there's so many, I mean, if I had a list of people to thank, Craigslist would run out of lists. So, you know.
That's great, though. I think that's perfect for you. So
yeah, definitely.
Okay, so Brian is selling these hats, and how can we get them?
Going to the actors.
I believe the Actors Anarchy page is Brian's page. And
we have a doc on the page that you could just go right there and link.
Right.
And then it will have everything that Brian is selling in his shop.
Yes.
And we are also working on These are a new product we're working on.
Try them on.
Oops, you're kind of sloppy here.
Let's go ahead and I'll help you.
Is
oh, that's beautiful.
China White T-shirts. Mm-hmm. That we're not exactly sure how we're marketing this one.
We're not. Back. We haven't made final. You got to turn it around.
I know. I did back. I did front and back.
Oh, okay. Sorry,
I was moving too quickly.
I don't think they care about the back.
Yeah, we have this product also that is going to be coming out.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Okay, so.
I don't know what size is that one here.
I believe that's medium. I thought, medium, and this is small.
Okay, this one was for you, and this one was
me?
For you.
Me?
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
I'm so excited. Matches my hat.
Exactly.
I'll take the bag.
Oh, this is great.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations.
You know, those are hot off the press as of yesterday, so we're
Oh, these are great. So visit and buy some to help finance the China White film. And how else are we doing like an Indiegogo
for
that?
Yes, I have an Indiegogo for China White, and I also have an Indiegogo for Silence.
Oh, that's
okay.
Good.
And I'm working on many other contacts that I have. And so I'm in business meetings quite a bit, mm-hmm. and trying to nail down the funding. We got a little bit off target when one financing or investor promised the money, but when it came down to me asking for it because I needed it to start filming, they didn't come through, and contracts didn't come through. So I was misled, and I'm disappointed by it. But we move on, and we'll find others.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, that's...
It was very disappointing.
Did they just say they didn't have the funds?
No, they never told me they didn't have the funds. They just... When I asked for performance, it didn't come through.
Okay, well,
they promised they did, but it didn't work out.
Okay, well, I mean, I know that with your contacts that there's going to be no problems in funding, but visit our Indiegogo campaign for both China White and for Silence.
Yeah.
And you can find the links on our Facebook page.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Correct. Very much so.
Or just go to Indiegogo.com and then put under Silence or China White, and it will go right to the site.
Yeah.
Okay. And China White starts filming November 5th in New Jersey.
Correct.
Are you going to be on the set?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Oh, was that too quick? No.
Too soon.
No, a woman of decisiveness here.
You know,
the perfect
timing.
Person to be in charge of the family.
Yeah, I'll be in charge, but I'll be behind the scenes. They don't need me on the set.
Okay. Well, again, thank you very much.
Thanks.
You for the hat and the shirt. And I'm so proud to be a part of this family, and now you can see why. I've done a show with Shannon and with Todd now, and I'm just really honored to be working with such amazing people.
Well,
starting
we're honored
with
that
Suzanne.
You actually wanted to interview us. Thank you
exactly.
very much.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time.
Yes.
And thank you to our audience for tuning in today. And thank you to Renah for filming and editing this.
Thank you, Renah.